At this stage of my presentation, we are only sure about this function that the derivative is equal to 0 for 6 plus 7 values between 0 and 2 pi. We are sure that for 6 of these values, the function is equal to the same value here, and for the 7 other values, we are sure that we have the same values also. For the maximum conjecture, this value, for the minimum conjecture, this value. But this number is superior to this one, or this one superior to this one? Can we check that these numbers are really maximum and this number are really minimum? So, can we verify that that is always superior to that? So we can do it. If we subtract these two numbers and we display the sign of this function, you can see that the sign is always positive because this number, this curve has the same height. So what about the three functions we have to to add, and we call them g, I remind you that, and dg, the derivative. So let us see the three curves, and the value of c. And you can see that between 0 and pi divided by 6, two functions are increasing and a third one is decreasing. But what about the sum? And you can check that if we increase 2 pi divided by 6, 3 pi, etc., etc., we will see in zooming what happened. And you can see that between 0 and pi divided by 6, the function seems to be decreasing. The minimum is obtained from 0 for pi divided by 6. And you see that maximum 2 pi divided, 3 pi divided by 6, etc., etc., minimum, maximum, maximum, minimum, etc., etc. And it doesn't change if we change the value of c. We'll not do it because the curve will probably go outside of the figure because of the zoom. So as we were unable with the CAS to prove that this function was like this, decreasing, increasing, increasing, etc., etc., we'll try to simplify the problem, especially the expression of this sum. So let us remark that this sum is equal to 0. Very easy to prove it with the complex number. Therefore, the sum of our three very complex functions is equal to this one. So we avoid to take this one, which is here. Eventually, if ffx is equal to that, the function we have to study is this one, ffx plus ffx minus 2 pi divided by 3 plus this one. So we can notice that this difference is equal to 0. So this function is an even function. And also we can notice that we have that. Then ff is periodic and period pi divided by 3. Therefore, we need only to prove that this function is decreasing on the interval 0 pi divided by 6. So you can notice that if we call jjjx the derivative for 0 and pi divided by 6, the derivative is equal to 0. So if there is a minimum and okay, so let's continue. So what about the sign of the derivative? If we display the curve of the sine of the derivative, you can see here that you have minus 1 and here plus 1. Between 0 and pi divided by 6, the derivative for the CAS is negative. For all values of C, you can see, if I change the value of C, it works always. So what about the curvature at 0 and pi divided by 6? It depends of the second derivative. So you can see that if we call G the second derivative, the sine of the second derivative at 0 is negative, at pi divided by 6 is positive, which means that locally at 0 the function decreases, and arriving at pi divided by 6 is always decreasing because of the curvature. What about the sine in between? It's negative. And is it always the case? Is it always the case for different value of C? If we change C, you see that number is always negative, always positive. So the curves start decreasing, arriving decreasing, but in between we don't know what happened. The derivative is always negative, we don't know. So look at this number, we'll give a validation with a table of what happened. So you see here, we have a second sequence of value between 0 and pi divided by 6, and we have divided in 200 parts this interval, but we have displayed in this column only from 1 to 199. We have evaluated here the derivative, yeah, and here the sine of the derivative. And if we add all the value of this column, we find what we have here, minus 199, which means that all the numbers are negative. So for all the number of our subdivision, the derivative is negative. If we increase the number of the subdivision, we have always the same result. I've tried with 200, 500, 1000, it works. But it's not a proof. It's not a proof.